BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Marston. Unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music.
So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Globe here in Hay-on-Wye. This next act, I'm going to read what the Slap magazine in Worcester wrote about them. Bolt of Eagles already earned a serious reputation for delivering solid, edgy, hard-hitting rock, and the urge to watch and listen increases every time you see them perform. As their live show powers through dynamic sets of twisted 70s-inspired grooves, Vault of Eagles create a vast sonic spectrum that surely is the envy of many three-piece bands far and wide. I couldn't say it any better. Ladies and gentlemen, Vault of Eagles!
Chains.
Undiscovered.
And Under the Radar Music.
So here I am then, backstage with Vault of Eagles, three piece. That means one's called Vault, the other one's called Off, and the other one's Eagle. Is that how it all works?
That's right.
Okay, good. So Bewdley is where it's at. And we were discussing a little bit earlier on about just sort of how many acts there are in Bewdley. And I was saying there wasn't many. Then we came up with Gwyn Ashton. Then we came up with Naked Remedy, Riding Giants, Shaking Trees, Becky Hill.
Yeah.
So you're just kind of a long list of achievements from the town.
Yeah.
So where have your kind of travels taken you as a band?
All over the place, really.
Yeah. Really neat.
Yeah. That was a good one.
That was a good gig.
Was that with This Wicked Tongue not too long ago, which Andy O'Hare went
Andy's
to?
Andy's hometown.
Yeah, came down for the ride.
Is that the one where they didn't put enough diesel in the van and it ran out?
Yeah, we had to push it halfway down the road.
Brilliant. Okay.
Got there in the end, though.
Is that the most rock and roll story of your career so far?
Probably shouldn't mention the most rock and roll story.
And I suppose you have to tone it down with women in the band as well. It's
I don't know about that. Really? It's pretty fair.
Yeah, right. We're worse than Scotty's.
Oh, yeah, I'm the most not behaved.
That's what I wanted to hear. Because I always see your name on the gig listings, but I also see your name equally, you know, playing places like Birmingham all over.
Yeah, we try and gig as far afield and locally as possible, really, and just play as much as we can. We work a lot with local bands like Man Size, This Wicked Tongue and Das Sexy Clap, like trying to build a good scene in Worcester. Those are some of the best gigs, to be honest.
And I suppose they've also got like-minded fans as well.
Yeah, exactly. It's a lot of mutual fan base.
And that's pretty much what's happening on the national scene, you know, or even international. You see people like Rihanna teaming up with people like Calvin Harris, and all of a sudden Calvin Harris is huge in the States, and it works both ways. So I suppose tying in with shows by other local artists means that you also get to nick their fans, so to speak.
That's what it's all about, isn't it?
That's
the way it works. And
it's more fun like that as well. There's nothing better than just working with great people. And
and when you're doing these shows, as well, in places like London, it can be hard enough to get people to come along to your own gigs in your own city.
It's a bit hit and miss sometimes, but we've built up a fair bit. Like, it's better working with London bands as well, because then it's kind of more of an impact and people generally come down more, don't they?
Yeah, we're lucky because we do get people wherever we play. It's kind of cool, really, the way it works out.
Right.
We've not had a bad show in London yet, but I don't want to tempt fate.
Am I right in thinking that music's now full-time for you guys?
Yeah. Pretty much, yeah. I mean, it is, because we manage ourselves and we do everything.
Well, you know, we're looking for a manager, really, and some to take it a bit out of our hands and get more out there. But at the moment, we're kind of doing everything ourselves, really.
And that's an interesting mantra, because I was speaking to Andy Maynard of This Wicked Tongue, and he was saying, you know, if you've got a band and you've got five people in that band and they spend 7 hours a day marketing themselves across a year, that could be worth £100,000 worth of investment, because, you know, the wages are what are in London and what these record labels are being paid. So you're kind of finding that, are you? You're spending all the hours mainly pushing yourselves, not writing music.
Exactly.
It's a balance that we've got trouble with that at the moment, really.
It kind of depletes your
energy
to
be creative.
But then that kind of comes in bursts as well. You start writing, keeps flowing, and then you can't do any admin because you can't interrupt that. You have to let it just roll, don't you?
Yeah, we try and make every aspect creative, if you know what I mean. Like, whether it's like the business thing, like Hetty does all the artwork,
like with all the posts
and the t-shirts, we do all the merch.
I did notice the t-shirt which was hanging over the drum kit today.
Yeah. I mean, if you were to just get all that done, then it probably wouldn't be a creative process.
And that's fun in itself, isn't it? Is being creative that way as well as being in music.
Mm. Yeah, totally.
And I'm bound to ask, Vault of Eagles, who came up with that one?
Well, just kind of came.
It's like imagery.
Yeah, really.
An image, right?
Imagery,
symbolism.
Okay. Well, there's one image with a vault, there's another image with eagles. How did the two come together?
I don't know, I just imagine a vault opening and then eagles
kind of
just
like
flying out.
Normally that's bats, isn't it?
Kind of place.
No, I like it.
First out.
I like it. You know, that's always the most difficult decision for a band, is coming up with the sound of a band name which reflects the sound of what you've got on stage.
Yeah,
we are Vault of Eagles, every aspect. That name represents everything that we're about.
And are you kind of listening to the same music as what you're playing?
We've got so many different influences as well.
I actually get stressed because there's so much music I need to listen to. I don't have time to just get
welcome to my world.
But I like
it's
that.
People like that you really respect music as well, telling you, I listen to this band, write it down, and then have to cram
we've
in
got
the
lists
time.
Between us. We've probably got lists of things we need to check out.
That's true. Everyone will always tell you to check something out. But I suppose the biggest advice of the lot is don't listen to any of them. Just listen to what you're doing, because, you know, you need to be unique.
That's it, man.
And that's certainly what you did today, so well done.
Thanks.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester.
With Andrew Master.
Be part of it.
One's called Insanity.
Performing live here at the Globe in Hay-on-Wye, they are Mary, Hetty and Scott from Bewdley. Vault of Eagles!
Listen to hundreds of live gigs.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
I'm Ali from Malvern. I think they've got a really interesting sound. They're quite up and coming. They're very unique.
I was pretty impressed, actually. I think they've got a cracking sound and they look good. I don't think they look out of place supporting Babes in Toyland, if anyone remembers those.
Ooh.
Babes in Toyland. Check those out.
Okay, we'll take those, definitely take those out.
I'm Ali from Ross-on-Wye. I love the change of beat from sort of like quite melodic to sort of like real rock. It was a great tempo change.
Hi, what's your name and where are you from?
Linda from Hereford. I thought they were very good and I loved her voice.
Hi, I'm Mike from Ross. Oh, I loved them. They were really good. Great harmonies. Best part of it for me was when they both sang together. Excellent. Drummer, great as well. Good sound, all right.
He was an award-winning drummer last year at the Marshall Amps Battle of the Bands. By the
way. Oh, fantastic. Yeah, I mean, you could tell he was good, definitely.
John Price and I from Kington. Stupendous, weren't they?
That doesn't come across very well.
It doesn't, does it?
No.
No. Yeah, really good, yes.
I'm Hazel, I'm from Kington.
And what do you think of Vault of Eagles?
I thought they were fantastic.
Hi, I'm Helen, I'm from Ross. I thought they were excellent, very good. A lot of energy, very good.
Text 81333
and start your message with HW.
BBC introducing.
Be part of it.
In Hereford and Worcester.